Never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, never would have made it. Never could have made it without you. I would have lost it all. But now I see how you were there for me, and I can say, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over all you brought me through, I can see that you are the one I held on to, and I never,
never would have made it.
Oh, I never could have made it.
Somebody just need to testify to somebody next to him. Tell him, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, much better. When I look back over what he brought me through, I realize I made it because I had you to hold on to. Now I'm stronger. Now I'm wiser, I'm better, so much better. I made it. Is there anybody in this house other than me that could declare you made it? Tell your neighbor, never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Tell him, never could have made it. Oh, I wish I had some help here. I wish I had just two or three people that would just declare it. Never would have made it.
Never would have made it.
Never could have made it.
Never could have made it.
I just love to encourage myself. Sometimes I just look in the mirror and say, I'm strong.
Good morning, St. Paul family. My name is Camille Roddy, and I'm so honored to be with you today for worship. I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made, and let us all rejoice together and be glad in it. It is so good to be with you today, even virtually, giving thanks and praise to God. So I want to thank each of you for gathering wherever you may be for worship on this Lord's Day. Whether you are with us every Sunday, or if this is your first time joining us, that you chose to be here is such a blessing, and I trust it won't be our last time together. Now, let us invoke the presence of God's light into your worship space with a word of prayer. Gracious and most heavenly Father, we pause this morning just to say thank you. God, I thank you for those that are under the sound of my voice. We've come through a work week, and now we have gathered here today and ask that you open our minds, our hearts, and our spirits so that your Holy Spirit can rain down on us, pour into us your light and your love to word and song, so that when we leave this place and space, we walk out empowered with your Spirit and your love so that others may be drawn to you and they too will want to have a closer walk with you. It is in the blessed name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. Now let us continue in worship with a song from our very own Christina Sutler.
Good morning, St. Paul. Good morning, visitors. We come this morning to praise the Lord and worship him, because he has been so good. You're going to tell him just how good he is and what he means to us. If you know it, sing along. God is,
God is,
hey,
my everything.
God is,
God is,
yes he is,
my everything.
He's my joy,
he's my joy,
yes. He's my hope.
He's my hope for tomorrow.
He's my rock.
He's my rock
in a weary land.
Weary land.
A shelter.
A shelter in
hey.
Time of storm.
God is.
God is.
God is.
God is
my everything.
My everything.
Yes, he is. Hey, God is. Oh,
God is
my everything.
My
God is,
God is,
yes,
my
he's my joy,
he's my joy in sorrow,
he's my hope,
he's my hope for tomorrow,
yes he is, he's my rock,
he's my rock
in a weary land,
land.
My shelter, oh yes you are, God is,
God is,
God is my everything.
Woo!
Hey, my God is, woo! My everything. God is, yeah! He's my joy. Woo! Yes, he is. He's my hope. Yes, you are, God. He's my rock. Hey! A cloud for me, a shelter. Yes, he is. God is.
God is.
God is.
God is.
God is.
My God is.
He's my joy in times of sorrow. He's the lifter of my head through this pandemic. He's been my protection, my joy, and my peace. Oh, he's my healer, my doctor, my provider, my all in all. He's my lily in that valley, my everything. Hey, oh, my everything. Hey, everything, everything, every little thing. My way maker, my bridge layer, my bright morning star. Every little beat of my heart, the blood running warm through my veins. My promise keeper, my way maker, my miracle worker. Oh, hey, my everything, my everything. He's been my strength when I was weak. He's been my heart, my soul and mind. The very air that I breathe. The very air that I breathe. My everything. My everything. My everything. My will and a will. My joy, my love. Hey! Yes, he has. Has he been your everything? Your all in all. When you didn't think you was gonna have anything, it was him. Well, he is everything. Woo! My everything. Hallelujah! Hallelujah to the King. Amen.
Well, St. Paul family, I have a few announcements for us today. For those who are used to giving to the church via Give Plus application, please note that this feature will no longer be available beginning the end of September. It is being replaced by the Vanco mobile application. If you are used to giving to the church via Give Plus, you will need to download a new application, Vanco mobile app, from your Google or Apple Play Store beginning in October, and then use this new application moving forward. Thank you, St. Paul family, for your faithful support. If you have any questions about the new application, be sure to contact Rita Brown in the office for assistance Monday through Friday between 9 a.m. and 12:30 p.m. This Wednesday, September 15th, the noon Bible study class will summarize the book of Acts and begin the book of Romans. Evening Bible study resumes on Wednesday, September 22nd at 7 o'clock p.m. Contact the office for needed links, passcodes, or telephone numbers. You can also see the church bulletin, which is located on our website, for additional information related to church activities, upcoming ministry meetings, and information related to accessing Bible study by Zoom. Now let's worship God with our tithes and offerings. In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7, it reads, "Each one should give what he has decided in his heart to give, not out of regret or compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver." Let this scripture guide us in giving back to God what has been provided to each one of us. If you are visiting with us today and wish to give to the church, we invite you to consider an offering to our missions ministry. All contributions to missions go back into the community to help meet the needs of our neighbors. We have four ways that you may give each week. First, you may give by visiting our website, www.stpaulumcws.org, then click Giving. There's also a giving app, Give Plus. This is available on both the Google Play Store as well as the Apple App Store. And remember, this is available through the end of September. You may also set up an electronic bank draft, or you may mail your gift to the church. Thank you, St. Paul, for your continued support. It is because of your generous stewardship, St. Paul is allowed to be a light that blesses others just as God has blessed us. Let us pray. Holy God of mercy, redemption, and grace, this morning we bring our gifts and pray that you will dedicate them to your work of love and reconnection with all of your children. These gifts seem so small when balanced against what Christ has given us and what you continue to give us through the Holy Spirit. In our giving, may we grow in our gratitude, trust, and faithfulness of you. It is in the name of Christ who gave all for us that we give back to you. Amen. Now, St. Paul family and friends, let us prepare our hearts and minds for a word from God by the shepherd of this house, Pastor Donald Jenkins.
It's prayer time, church family. And remember our biblical mandate for prayer. Don't worry about anything. Instead, pray about everything. Tell God what you need and thank God for all He has done. Hasn't He done a lot for you? Then you will experience God's peace, which exceeds anything we can understand. And God's peace will guard our hearts and minds as we live in Christ Jesus. Well, today, let's remember with thanksgiving and give God praise. Alexander Walker, we've been praying for him, and a liver became available, and it was successfully transplanted, and he is doing well. And let's pray and thank God for that great blessing. And let's thank God for the blessing of continued healing, that his body will fully accept this liver. And let's thank God for this marvelous testimony that Alexander will have about the goodness of God in his life. He already has been telling the story, and let's thank God for that. Well, let's ask God to be with a number of us who are still healing, and God can heal. God is the God who heals, and we thank God for that. We also have others who will be having surgery in the future, and we're thanking God in advance for the success of their surgeries. Keep all who are on our prayer list in our prayers. Remember the Hartsfield family who lost a nephew, so let's keep them in our prayers. I also remember that this is the 20th anniversary of 9/11, in which more than 3,000 lives were lost and just devastated our nation, brought us to a halt for a while. And we pray that God will move in our world, and that we, as disciples of Jesus Christ, might be the kind of people who will be peacemakers, who will live, and I'll talk about it this morning, by the wisdom of God. So in this season, as we remember the 20th anniversary of 9/11, let's pray for all of the families in our nation that have been affected by that tragedy. Well, let's go to God in prayer for these and other things. Most gracious Heavenly Father, you are good and kind, and we thank you for every good and every perfect gift that you give to us. We thank you that you don't treat us according to our works, but according to your grace and your mercy and your love. As we come this morning, we come first of all giving you thanks for every good and every perfect gift. And then we come to asking for forgiveness of the sins that we have committed, and ask that you would forgive us of each and every one, and help us to live in the future the lives that you have called us to live. Hear our prayer as we give you thanks for Alex Walker. Thank you for a liver that you made available. Thank you for a successful transplant. Thank you for all of the people who tended to his care. And thank you for the medicines that you had to come into existence so that those medicines may work in his body and bring to him health and wholeness. We declare and we thank you according to your word that every need is met according to your riches and glory for Alex and his family. And we thank you for all of those who stand by his side. We thank you for hearing our prayers this morning. We pray your blessing upon the world and upon our nation as we remember the awful tragedy of 9/11/01. And we pray, dear Heavenly Father, that you would help us to find ways of reaching out so that this will not happen again. But we do know that there is evil in this world, and that evil is not of your doing. So help us to live our lives in such a way that we would be the peacemakers that you want us to be. Thank you for this church, and thank you for all that you are doing in this church. And I pray your richest blessing upon us, that we might continue to thrive in this season, that we might continue to thrive in every way, that you might receive the glory and the praise. Thank you for that team of blessed persons that you are using to carve out how we might return to in-person worship and to begin doing more things, more ministry, more fellowship, more study, more worship in person, so that we might give you glory and praise. We pray your blessings upon all of us as we are absent from one another. We ask that you would watch over us and keep us. Thank you for keeping us strong. Thank you for keeping us together. And thank you for keeping us faithful. We continue to pray for those who have great needs. And we know that you will supply every need. You know every situation of those persons who are in worship now, of those persons who are members of this congregation, and of those persons who are members of the body of Christ, and of those persons who are in your world. You know their needs better than anyone else. And we pray and link ourselves together that you will supply that need according to your riches in glory. We are honored that you use us in ministry. So continue to touch our mouths and our hearts and our hands and our feet, that we might do what you want us to do. Help us never to give up or to give in. Help us always to walk by faith and not by sight. Now, for everything that is needful for mind, body, soul, and spirit, we know you will provide. And as you provide, we'll be careful to give your name the glory and the praise. Now we come together to worship you today. And there may be somebody who will be listening to us, listening to your word, listening to your preacher, listening to those who sing. And may you open the hearts of those who are listening. And if there is one who is listening, whom you are now calling into your family, please, dear Heavenly Father, help them to make that decision for you today. This is my prayer in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Now we'll be led in worship by our mass choir. And after the mass choir, the reading of the scripture and the preaching of God's word.
Under a heavy load, you wanna give up the fight, call it quits because your heart is broken in two. It seems nobody cares about your pain and your despair. The bottom line is you just don't know, hey, what to do. And even though you've asked the question why, God was there for you all the time in every way. Listen close, you'll hear him say,
church family. It's preaching time, and I invite you to take your Bibles and turn in your Old Testament to the book of Proverbs chapter 1, and we'll begin reading at verse 20. Proverbs chapter 1, and I'll begin reading at verse 20. Now, if you would be so kind to stand wherever you are and reverence the reading of God's Word. Proverbs in your Old Testament, chapter 1, and I'll begin reading at verse 20. Wisdom calls aloud outside. She raises her voice in the open squares. She cries out in the chief concourses. At the openings of the gates in the city, she speaks her words. How long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity? For scorners delight in their scorning, and fools hate knowledge. Turn at my rebuke. Surely I will pour out my spirit on you. I will make my words known to you. Because I have called and you refused, I have stretched out my hand and no one regarded. Because you disdained all my counsel and would have none of my rebuke, I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your terror comes. When your terror comes like a storm and your destruction comes like a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you. Then they will call on me, but I will not answer. They will seek me diligently, but they will not find me, because they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would have none of my counsel and despised my every rebuke. Therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their own way and be filled to the full with their own fancies. For the turning away of the simple will slay them, and the complacency of fools will destroy them. But whoever listens to me will dwell safely and will be secure without fear of evil. The grass withers and the flower fades, but the word of our God abides forever. Praise be to God, and please be seated. Today, think with me. The wisdom of God calls. The wisdom of God calls. How do we choose to live our lives? There are only two ways, you know. One way is by the wisdom of the world. We may choose to live our lives by the values of this world. Get all we can, keep all we get. Life is about us. Unless I or my group believes it, it is not true. Eat, drink, be merry, for this life is all there is. We can live our lives by the wisdom of the world. It's not a good way to live, but if we so choose, we can live our lives by the wisdom of this world, by the ways of this world. Look around, church family. The wisdom of the world leads to violence in our streets and our schools. The wisdom of this world leads to hunger and poverty. The wisdom of this world leads to evil leaders in high places, leads to lies being believed and truth being rejected. It leads to the top 1% holding all the wealth. It leads to a pandemic that has needlessly cost around 7,000 lives. It leads to children increasingly becoming victims of this awful violence. It leads to children increasingly becoming victims to the stupidity of adults. It leads to income inequality. It leads to a Christian church without faith. It leads to injustice everywhere. But there is a better choice. We can choose to live our lives by the wisdom of God. We can live according to His values, His word, His will, and His ways. We can consider the needs of others before our own. We can practice sharing our wealth. We can take the vaccine because it protects others. We can let justice roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. We can select leaders whose focus is on the poorest and the neediest among us. We can make guns hard to get. We can allow everyone to vote. We can be the head and not the tail. We can be the thermostat and not the thermometer. We can live our lives by the wisdom of God. And when we do, we make our life, we make this life, and we make this world a better place in which to live. The book of Proverbs calls us to living life not by our own understanding, but by the wisdom of God. Proverbs says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct our paths. Today's passage written by Solomon says, wisdom, the wisdom of God, that is, calls, cries out, hollers to this world. Live your lives, world, by the wisdom of God. Live your lives by the values of God. Live your lives in obedience to God. Live by the wisdom of God. Today's message is the same today as it was in Solomon's day. The wisdom of God cries out to people in the world, and the world still rejects God's wisdom. Today's passage names three kinds of people that were present then, and they're still present now. Look at verse 22. Talks about the simple ones, the scorners, and the fools. Well, the simple ones are the naive. They're the impressionable. They are faced with the options of good and evil and need help to make the right choice. Then there are the scorners or the mockers. They make fun and treat with contempt the wisdom of God. They make fun of the wisdom of God and those who seek to live by the wisdom of God, and they have contempt for the wisdom of God. They have their 15 minutes of experience, and they think those 15 minutes of experience are just as valid as the experience of Almighty God. Then you have the fools. The fools are those who just simply say, it is my way or the highway. They don't care about right and wrong. They don't care about the wisdom of God. Well, I think about all the people today who, for political reasons, diss the vaccines or talk about election security and a stolen election despite all the evidence to the contrary. That's foolish. The wisdom of God calls out to all of us and begs us to stop rejecting God. Wisdom cries out in verses 20 and 21. Wisdom speaks, however, throughout the scripture, throughout Proverbs. But wisdom also has a heart, in my judgment, of compassion. There is no celebration in the text because people reject the wisdom of God. But there is great sadness, like the sadness of Jeremiah, that great weeping prophet who cried over the rejection of God's people. There is in the text, in my judgment, this great sadness, like the sadness of Jesus, who sat down on a mountainside one day and looked over and saw Jerusalem, and he wept over it because they rejected him. There is with wisdom great sadness, but this wisdom cries out with a heart of compassion and says, listen, listen, listen. Look what the passage says here. Wisdom, the wisdom of God calls to all. To all. Verses 20 and 21. Wisdom calls aloud outside. She raises her voice in the open squares. She cries out in the chief concourses. At the openings of the gates of the city, she speaks her words. Wisdom cries, the wisdom of God cries out to all. In the open spaces, with the wisdom of God, it is not in some back room somewhere, just cutting deals with certain people or available to certain people. The wisdom of God is not partial. The wisdom of God is in the marketplace. It's in the places where we meet. It's in the places where people come in and go out. The wisdom of God calls out everywhere and to everybody. body, the wisdom of God invites everyone to live by the wisdom of God, and everybody can live by the wisdom of God. No matter how much money you have or don't have, or how much education you have or don't have, or how many degrees you have or don't have, no matter whether you have a pedigree or no pedigree, listen, the wisdom of God is available to everybody. And the wisdom of God calls out to everybody. If any of you lacks wisdom, says James, let him ask of God, who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to him. Whoever calls for wisdom, whoever would like to live by the wisdom of God, wisdom calls out to everybody, to all. Here's listen and live by the wisdom of God. That's good. That's good. That's good. Nobody is excluded. God can use anybody. God can place his wisdom in anybody. And we, anybody, any of us, if we so choose, can live by the life-giving wisdom of God. But then the wisdom of God calls to all to acceptance. That's verses 22 and 23. How long, you simple ones, will you love simplicity? For scorners delight in their scorning. Fools hate knowledge. Turn at my rebuke. Surely I will pour out my spirit on you. I will make my words known to you. Do you hear the invitation in those words? That the wisdom of God reaches out and calls out not for rejection, but for acceptance. Look, I want to pour my spirit on you. I want to make my words known to you, says the wisdom of God. So the wisdom of God calls out to all, but it calls out to all to accept, not reject, the wisdom of God. To paraphrase the words about God and salvation, instead of saying that God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance, I want to paraphrase that in a different way. The wisdom of God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. The wisdom of God takes no delight in what happens, and we'll talk about that in a minute, and what happens when we reject God's wisdom. The wisdom of God reaches out to the rebellious, reaches out to those who are rejecting, and longs and begs and weeps over them and desires to bring them to safety, to bring them into a life that is worth living, and they reject. But the wisdom of God cries out, accept, accept, accept my way of living. Do come out of the world. Come out of the world and be separate, says the Lord. Come out of the world and stop living by the deathly wisdom of the world. Come out of the world and live by the wisdom of God. The invitation is come, accept the wisdom of God. Live life by the wisdom of God. Then the wisdom of God calls all to accountability. Verses 24 through 32. Here, read them with me again. Because, says the wisdom of God, I have called and you refused accountability. I have stretched out my hand and no one regarded. Because you disdained all my counsel, I tried to help you, and would have none of my rebuke. I tried to correct you. I also will laugh at your calamity. I will mock when your terror comes. When your terror comes like a storm, and your destruction comes like a whirlwind, when distress and anguish come upon you. Then you will call on me, but I will not answer. They will seek me diligently, but they will not find me, because they hated knowledge and did not choose the fear of the Lord. They would have none of my counsel and despised my every rebuke. Therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their own way and be filled to the full with their own fancies. For the turning away of the simple will slay them, and the complacency of fools will destroy them. The wisdom of God calls us to accountability. It is not God who perpetrates evil. It is not God who makes people go hungry. It is not God who makes people take up guns and make guns so available. It is not God who makes people elect the wrong leaders, storm capitals, hoard the wealth, live lies. It is not God who is the cause of all of the evil that's going on in this world. The wisdom of God hollers out today, it's our fault. We are accountable. We reject the wisdom of the living God in our lives. And since, says the wisdom of God, we reject God's wisdom, for as much as God reaches out to us, as much as God tries to help us, as much as God tries to teach us, as much as God tries to show us what the right way is, and we reject God, God laughs at our struggles, our calamities. God refuses to help us in our difficulties. God refuses to answer our prayers. God allows us to sleep in the bed that we have made. God allows us to destroy our very selves. So when we see all the violence, all the lunacy, all the stupidity, all the hunger, all the global warming, all the divisions, it is not of God's doing, it is our doing. And God takes a hands-off approach because he has already reached out to us and made it clear what the right pathway is. And we have rejected him. And we don't want God's advice, God's counsel, or God's guidance. We stand accountable. God will not stand before God's self and stand in judgment for all the evil that goes on. But you and I, this whole world, will stand before God, and we will be held accountable for the evil that's in this world. But the wisdom of God is calling out to say, you can live a better life. You can change the circumstances of your life and of your world. Live your life by the wisdom of God, by the wisdom of God, the will of God, the way of God, the word of God. Live life by the wisdom of God. And then when we do, wisdom hollers out and says to all, assurance. The wisdom of God calls all to assurance. That's the good news in the text. Verse 33, but whoever listens to me will dwell safely and will be secure without fear of evil. That's good news. If we accept God's wisdom, God does what God does. God steps forward to help. And for those who live by God's wisdom, listen to this. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. For those who live by God's wisdom, listen to this. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, you shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you. When you live by the wisdom of God, 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Nothing shall separate you from the love of God when you live by the wisdom of God. We are more than conquerors through Him who loved us when we live by the wisdom of God. And we have that assurance, that blessed assurance, that not only are we on God's side, but God is on our side. God will fight our battles. God will take care of us. God will provide for our every need. God will lead us through difficult situations. God will be with us in our storms. When we live our lives by the wisdom of God, we are assured of the presence and the protection and the power, and the person of God being present in our lives. When we live by the wisdom of God, we have that blessed assurance. Oh, isn't that good news? Oh, somebody just got help right there. Isn't that good news? That you are more than a conqueror, that no weapon formed against you shall prosper. And so many others can be falling, and so many others can be succumbing to this world, and God is punishing them. It does not have to happen to you because you live by the wisdom of God. So how will we choose to live our lives? The world has its so-called wisdom. The world has its so-called wisdom. There is no future in living by the world's wisdom, but God has true wisdom. God's wisdom calls us to listen. God's wisdom calls us to be guided by, and God's wisdom calls us to accept His wisdom. And when that happens, you and I become the salt and the light and the disciples that God saved us to be. I don't know about you, but it is my life's goal to live by the wisdom of God. How about you? How about you? Let us pray. Gracious and all-wise God, thank you for your word. And by your word, you instruct us how to live by your wisdom. And as we do that, you're always giving us promises that you will never leave us or forsake us, that you are right there with us, and that you never let us get in the boat of life when the storms hit, that you are not there also. So we thank you for that. I pray now for someone who needs to make a decision to accept your wisdom as the guiding light, guiding principle, guiding value of their lives. They can see, feel, touch the world's wisdom, and they can see how detrimental and destructive the world's wisdom is. But I'm asking you to call forth from them the faith to know that living your way is the best way. Living by your wisdom is the best way. Help them to become today disciples of Jesus Christ. And if we have some people who are disciples and they're teetering on the fence of the world and you, I'm praying that you will nudge them over, lean them over to your side, to come out of living by the world's wisdom, and to live by your wisdom. Help us not to be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ and help us not to be ashamed of you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. If you've not made a decision for Christ, then I would invite you to do that today. Let me invite you to give us a call at 336-723-4531 or contact us at info@stpaulumcws.org and let us help you with that decision of faith in Christ that allows God to live in you and to allow His wisdom to live through you. But then if you are in the city and you need a church home, it is wise to connect with the church. The wisdom of God will never lead you away from church, but the wisdom of God will always lead you to God's people as a member of the body of Christ. So if you're in the city without a church home, we invite you to allow us to be your church family. And you may use that same telephone number, 336-723-4531, or that same email, info@stpaulumcws.org, to make known your wish to be a member of this church. Well, as you are making that decision, our St. Paul Virtual Mass Choir comes now to lead us in worship.
That is like no other. There is strength that will pull you through.
Yes.
There is God standing in your corner. There is nothing, nothing He can't do. There is grace that has no measure. There is mercy that has no end. There is life for you. There is joy and pleasure. There is God. He's your closest friend. Everybody say mercy that has no end. Oh, there is life for you. There is joy and pleasure too. There is God. He's your closest friend. Come on and say
there is hope
all around.
Thank you, church family, and our honored guests for being with us on this day. Next Sunday, we ask you to come back and be with us again. Historically, that's Men's Day. So I'm preparing something for Men's Day next Sunday, the third Sunday in September. So please come back and join us. This week, I had opportunity to go through our email lists and our membership lists. And I went through my email list and saw how many people were on there, and I knew all of them. And then our membership list, and I saw the people on there, I knew all of them. And then within those lists, there are our children, and I know all of them. And I'm looking forward. My heart just longed to be with you, for us to be together in the sanctuary, to worship together. Well, we're going to do that as soon as we can. As soon as we safely can. But I do want you to know that you are in my heart. You are in my thoughts, and you are in my prayers. And I miss you greatly, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Now receive this benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Be safe. Be well. And I love you. God bless you. See you next week.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Yeah. Let the church, let them say amen. If you believe the word, let the whole church say amen. God has spoken, so let the church say amen. Lift your hands, lift your hands. God has spoken. So let the church say amen. Oh, thank you, Lord. God has spoken. So let the church say amen.
Everybody
say amen.
God
has spoken.
So let the church,
say amen.
Yeah. Can I get a witness?
Let the church say amen.
To what his plans are.
Let the church
to what his word says.
Let the church
say
amen.
Ooh, yeah, yeah.
make this your response.
Amen.
To whatever he said.
Amen.
From the healing of your body.
Amen.
To the raising of the dead.
Amen.
No matter how you're feeling.
Amen.
Or how your world is reeling.
Amen.
Battle on through the night.
Amen.
'Cause you're gonna win the fight.
Amen.
Standing at your Red Sea.
Amen.
Continue to say.
Amen.
'Cause your help is on the way.
Amen.
Why God has spoken. I heard him. So let the church say.
Amen.
Oh. Lift your hands wherever you are and let the church. Church
say,
God has spoken.
God has spoken.
Hallelujah.
Let the church
say.